Okay, so we're really fortunate for the next few little segments to be able to talk to Dr. Neil Lay. And Dr. Lay, thank you for stopping by. Dr. Lay is very interesting because she's got a very unique perspective. Her resume is pretty diverse. She graduated from Boston University with a DMD, and she's worked in DSO. She's worked in nonprofits. She's worked in the biggest laboratory that there is, along with other places, is doing some research and development along with that. And now she's a special consultant for some insurance companies. And it was with that particular experience that we wanted to talk about a couple things, and we wanted to be able to pick her brain a little bit. I think that she's got some great tips, and we're calling them tips and tricks, but it's basically just what she sees and how to not have to deny a claim. I think that there's a misconception out there, right, Dr. Lay, that maybe people feel like insurance companies want to do that.
Absolutely. And you know what? That's not true. You know, I have a friend in private practice right now, and he calls me up all the time, and when he has a question about, you know, how do I get something approved, or do you deny based on, you know, do you get a bonus or an incentive to deny these claims, or you have a certain amount of claims you have to deny? That is absolutely not true. There is no bonus. There is no quota that we have to deny a certain amount of claims. We want you to get paid. You know, we're trying to be as provider friendly as possible, and we're here to help you out. Unfortunately, you know, due to the lack of communication or just the quality of the x-rays that we receive, we can't approve the claim. You know, you as providers, you have the benefit of the patient in the chair. You have nice fancy digital radiographs in your office, and you can change the contrast. We don't have that. A lot of times what we get is just a little snapshot of what you're requesting. And so I, you know, a lot of times tell providers, please communicate with us what you're requesting so that we understand. So for example, if you're requesting a root canal on tooth number 30, and you send me just a PA and all I see is molar, and I have no other landmarks, I don't see tooth number 29 beside it, I don't see tooth number 31 beside it, there's no way for me to really know whether that is actually in fact tooth number 30 rather than tooth number 31, for example. So had the provider submitted just a bite wing or, you know, a full mouth x-ray, or even had he just pointed to the tooth and said, this is tooth number 30, then that would have been enough communication for me to allow that root canal.
No, and I think that's a very good point. And you know, as we were chatting previously, you know, you and I thought that there were so many little things that'll make a big difference to make things more efficient and streamline things for the clinicians when they submit. And I think that that'll help. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a few segments. We're going to take one question at a time and one topic at a time. And hopefully this is advantageous for you guys out there. And we'll see you again next time. All right. Thanks.